Welcome to the VMblog interview series. Today, we're happy to have with us Ziad Lammam, who's the Vice President of Product Management for Teradici. Welcome.
Thank you. Nice to be here.
So I guess we'll kick things off. I wanted to ask you, with COVID-19 outbreak forcing, you know, many companies to close their offices, can you talk about how Teradici is positioned to handle the demands of organizations as they quickly moved to a work from home scenario?
Yeah, for sure. Actually, this story started with us, with Teradici. We had to work from home like many of the rest of the world. And so that story really started with us. We talked to the employees one day in March, and everyone ended up working from home the very next day. We were actually using our own virtual desktop technology, and pretty much everybody was on a cloud desktop on one of the public clouds. So we all moved to working from home. And so there was kind of that moment of, you know, helping our own staff. But then we quickly moved to a position where we're able to help many of our customers do the same thing. So that was kind of a quick shift for us, but a good one. You know, as we moved to a work from home environment, we kind of found there were sort of three types of urgent demands from our customers. One was those who were already virtualized. They really needed to expand their deployments very quickly. And that was probably easier to do because they were very familiar with the virtualization solutions. And then there was kind of that second group of customers who hadn't virtualized yet, but needed to do it very quickly. So that's kind of another group that we helped out. And then there was also some interesting use cases that came out around maybe even just remoting a physical PC and not moving to a full virtualized environment. So we had to respond as Teradici to offer, number one, some flexible short-term licenses and trial licenses to really just get everyone going as quickly as possible. So that's kind of the first thing we did in terms of our response. And then we definitely kind of increased our focus on customer support, right? So we vectored more of the organization to help on the customer support front, and even adjusted some of our development priorities to address some of these new use cases that have emerged in the work from home environment. And then lastly, a ton of new content. We created these new rapid response guides, a new microsite. Just wanted to make it really easy for anyone who needed to get up and going very quickly to find the information that they needed to find.
And Ziad, like yourself, we're both very passionate about, you know, virtual desktops. It's been one of the things that we've been following for the past 20 years. What makes you passionate about what Teradici does?
Yeah, for sure. We have been in this industry for many years and have both seen it evolve, right, in so many ways, from hardware days to VDI to desktop as a service and cloud. And, you know, for me, what I'm most passionate about is that whole end user computing space. And why is that? It really relates to so many different industries. You know, it can be office workers like you and I who are communicating here today. And it can be power users, right, who are creating all the content that we're watching in the evening on all the streaming services. So it really spans a wide variety of industries, and it touches the end user, users like you and I, content creators, editors. And that's really what keeps it interesting and passionate for me. So it's really gratifying to be able to actually help end users like ourselves meet their business requirements by, you know, removing some of the blockades or the barriers that technology can do, and, you know, help them move forward. I would say the other thing is, you know, Teradici is a partner first organization. So I really enjoy working with a wide variety of different partners. And there are so many other great partners in the end user computing space, from the public cloud providers to the OEMs and the graphics providers and the ISVs, lots of really great partners out there, all looking to help end users essentially.
And what's a trend in the virtualization space that you want Teradici to capitalize on in the near future?
For me, I think, you know, the whole trend is around hybrid and multi-cloud workloads, right? And that's a lot of words. You know, what do they mean? It's really what we're seeing out in the market today, which is customers are wanting to take advantage of their data center environments, as well as all of the new flexibility that's out there in the public cloud. So it's really that mixed environment, using the infrastructure that's going to deliver, you know, the best experience that their users need. And I mean, just based on what's going on today in the world in this global pandemic, that's driving an even greater demand for hybrid and multi-cloud workloads. So we really think that, you know, that's kind of where, you know, everybody needs to play. And specifically for Teradici, we've been developing our solution to be able to support a wide variety of environments, both hybrid and multi-cloud. You know, over the past year, we've recently introduced something called Cloud Access Manager, for example, which is a control plane that allows customers to really easily provision and manage their virtual desktops remotely. Just in this past little while, as everyone moved to a work from home environment, we had a huge spike in demand for this management tool, because it allowed administrators to quickly deploy and provision those virtual desktops from their home as well. So it's great to see that increased use to keep those users online. And then I'd say, you know, there's also a lot of good options now, whether you want to deploy a desktop on AWS, Azure, Google Cloud, or in an on-premises environment. There's just so many options out there available today with GPU instances, without GPUs. I mean, it really is a game changer right now to be able to run in those hybrid environments. We've seen evolution too, like the introduction of Azure Stack, providing organizations flexibility to use the cloud in more of that private data center type environment. And then hyper-converged platforms from HPE, for example, that support even the most demanding users are now available. And we're working with partners like that to offer solutions to customers.
And what would you say to CIOs and senior IT directors when it comes to virtualizing their desktops?
Oh, I would say, you know, I mean, there's no better time to do it than now. It's the technology is definitely mature. It's widely available. And, you know, I would say if you haven't already made the shift, really start looking into it and start making that shift to take advantage of all this flexibility that I just described. It's there, it's available. It can really empower a business to, you know, work more efficiently and grow their business. So I would say, you know, make use of that. Look at what works best for you. And if anything, this pandemic has really taught us that, you know, we should really be prepared the next time to enable scaling this remote work environment that we're all in. And, you know, to be prepared in case it either gets sort of worse or better or fluctuates over the years. I would just say it's possible. You know, it's been amazing to see every industry in the world actually embrace remote work and show that we can do this. So I think that's going to be the new normal, as a large percentage of the world will be working remote going forward. They've shown that they can do it. And so just take advantage of the technology that's out there in your business and for your needs.
And with everything going on, is there any, you know, unexpected use cases that may have worked out well for Teradici's products?
Yeah, I mean, it kind of spans a lot of things as well. You know, traditionally, a work from home environment required something like a complex VPN, you know, to get remote access. And that's kind of what everybody got used to in the old days. And that's not needed anymore. So, you know, we found a lot of interest in our solution For the simple example of, you know, not requiring VPN access, it makes it super easy to get online from home. So there's sort of, you know, simple technology reasons like that, up to real business drivers too. So we found a quick uptake in our technology to enable global talent. So you know, we're in different locations here speaking on this interview, and we're finding more organizations actually take the plunge because they realize they can enable global talent in, you know, different cities in their own country, but also different cities in other countries as well. That's been a real game changer and a way for companies to really move forward. And that was before, you know, the pandemic hit us, and it's happening even more now, but it's certainly happening a lot. And then, you know, then on the use case front, we're seeing things like video editors, all the news and the live TV content we all watch on TV, that all has to continue. And, you know, it's been great to help the broadcast community. Teradici's been actively helping broadcast network customers worldwide to really continue to deliver that content and remotely edit it in facilities at home. So that's been a real game changer. There's even been shows like Survivor South Africa that have been using remote editing technology to, you know, take care of production in really harsh environments. And then probably the last use case that's really bubbled up quite a bit, is not surprising, is the disaster recovery scenario. So I think we all have learned that, you know, let's be prepared for this next time around. And like I said, there's really great ways to do that with the technology today, and to prepare for that disaster or pandemic if it happens again.
And since you've been in the industry for a while, what would you say to people who, you know, may have known you from the past, and they haven't really been following or keeping up to date with Teradici? What has your progress been since then?
Oh, yeah, you know, it's something I think maybe a lot of people are surprised with, and hopefully, you know, this conversation has helped shed some light on that. Teradici has really evolved in our enterprise software portfolio over the past many years and in many, many different areas. So, you know, from a technology perspective, we've expanded the virtual desktop and virtual workstation solutions that we offer. You can see that we support Windows and Linux workloads and a wide variety of endpoint devices. Adding these hybrid and multi-cloud options to your deployments, whether you're interested in a public cloud only environment, a mixed environment, or a pure data center environment. We really have focused on all three of those areas. And providing a really easy to use management plane, that was a pretty big evolution for us as well. You know, we've always been known as that protocol company. So we're doing a lot more than protocol, but we certainly continue to develop the PCoIP protocol. And some of the recent enhancements under the PCoIP Ultra umbrella have really taken that user experience to the next level. Higher resolution, higher frame rates, multiple monitors, really great responsiveness. And so you've seen us continue to invest in that protocol as user demands keep increasing as well. And then also adding new secure endpoints. So secure zero clients, secure thin clients, and then a wide variety of software endpoints too. From a technology perspective, you know, we're much more than protocol today. That's definitely something we invest in, but certainly that entire remote end-to-end solution is something that we're focusing on. And then on the other side of the coin, from a partnership perspective, I would say we've expanded our partnerships and new initiatives within each of those partnerships. So whether it's working with AWS, Azure, or Google Cloud on the cloud provider front, or many of our OEMs like Dell and HP and LG and iGel on server or workstation or endpoint solutions, We've recently expanded to partner with the ISV community. So you'll see a lot of great new services and solutions from ISV partners and Teradici like Avid, Adobe, and Autodesk. So really from a partnership perspective, that's something that's evolved and continues to evolve. So, I mean, I would just say stay tuned. You're going to see Teradici continue to evolve on the technology front. We've got a lot of exciting new things planned. And also on the partnership front, we're sticking to our partner-first roots, and you'll see many more partner solutions and partnerships coming forward. So,
well, great. Before we let you go, you talked a bit earlier about assets, demos, microsites. What's the best place for audience viewers to go to find out more information about what Teradici's up to?
So today, you know, if anyone's looking for help with that remote work solution, we really have curated and created a lot of content specifically to get you online. And that's a really simple place to go, teradici.com/remote work. Of course, if you can't find that, or you can't remember that, teradici.com will, you know, provide you with a lot of the information that I covered here today. And there's an easy way to contact us through our homepage.
Well, great. Well, thanks again for taking time to speak with VMblog today and for catching us up with everything that Teradici is up to right now.
Thank you very much, guys. Great speaking with you.
I hope you enjoyed this video. If you'd like to see more of these VMblog videos, please hit the like button and subscribe. And it's important, if you want to get notified the next time we post a video, please hit the subscribe and the bell notification.